Hallelujah, glory to God. What a mighty God we serve. World is locked down. We are not having church. But wherever we have to worship God in spirit and truth. Before we go to the word of God, let us look unto God for His guidance. Father, I praise Thee. Worship and adore Thee. Magnify the glorious name, Master. You are wonder. You are mighty. You are eternal. You are wisdom. You are holiness. You are justice. You are our inner master. You are our everything. So God the Father, you please take control of my master. Lord the Father, speak to me and speak through me. Heal your people, Master. That the people can be blessed. Lord the Father, do great thing in our midst. I give all the glory and honor to you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Today, our topic is, what are the things we should not have? So many times, we are not bothering about many things. But when we look into the Bible, there we can see some of the things we should not have. First, James 4:6 says, pride. Man, one who gets pride, no? His life will be not blessed. Bible says, Lord, resist the proud. Yes, Lord, resist the proud people, but give grace to the humble one. If you are a man of humble, you can be lifted up. When pride enters in our life, that is the last day for our life. Pride appearing above others, haughty. We should not appear others above than others. What we are to be. When we look into Proverbs chapter 8, 13, Lord hates pride. So in our life, pride should not come. Lord, the Creator, the Lord one who died for us, the Lord one humbled himself, he hates pride people. So we must have be a man of simple, not of pride. When we look into Mark 7, verse 21 to 22, pride cometh out of the man. Yes, the defiled man. So be careful about pride. 1 John 2:16 says, pride of the life is not from the law, it is from the world. So we should not have pride in our life. Bible says, if pride comes down, we will fall down easily. Once what happened? One angel was thought, I will become equal to God. I will become higher than God. What happened? God sent him, he fell down from our heaven. Yes, he becomes Satan. Pride people are Satanic people. So we must have, not have pride, we must be a simple people. Second one is, Proverbs 3:31 says, envy. When envy enters into our life, we will not come up here. Psalm 73:3 says, we should not look into wicked's prosperity, foolish cheater's life. When we look into wicked's prosperity, we may have envy. God, I am so faithful, Master, but these people are cheaters. They are acting as the people of God, but they are cheaters. They are only for money. They are for family. Father God, we should not look unto the wicked. Yes, in Christian world also, in ministry world also, lot of wicked are there to hands in a wicked way. So, we should not have envy upon wicked ones. When Rachel was not having child, she got envy with her sister. She came to her husband, hey, give me child or I will die. When envy comes, it will lead us to die, commit suicide also. So envy should not be in us. People of God, when Joseph saw a dream, God told about his future to him. But what happened? He shot his brother because of envy of his of their brothers. They put him into cave. Yes, children of the law. They sold him. He lost. They thought, but God made him as a ruler of everyone. Philippians chapter 1:15 says, some people, some preachers, preaching of the Lord for envy. Yes, we should not serve the Lord with envy. They are also doing, I have to do. They are running, I have to do. In that envy motive, we should not serve God with humbleness, without call, without. We should not do anything. So we have to have call. That call also should become from God. We should not have envy in us. Proverbs 14:30 says, envy, the rootiness of the bones. Yes, when envy comes, no, our bones will collapse. 1 Peter 2:2 says, we have to lay aside envy also before read and meditate the word of God. With envy, if we read and meditate God's word, we will be in envy only. We will not be a people of sin. They are godly. So, get away from envy. Don't give root to envy to stay in our life. Envy, God hates that. Third one, 2 Timothy 4:14 says, evil. Hey, when you look at Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 3, the heart of the sons of man is full of evil. When we give our heart to Lord Jesus Christ, when we ask God's forgiveness, when God rules our heart will not tell evil. Children of the Lord, Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 15 says, before us good, death and evil are there. We should not choose evil, we have to choose good only. Before us there is a good, there is a death and evil. What kind of things we are selecting? We should not select evil. Children of the Lord, evil will lead us to death. Don't choose evil. World is full of evil. Romans chapter 12 verse 9 says, above, yet evil, we must yet abhor evil. Are we yet evil? How we become friends with evil? Amos 3:6 says, if there is evil in city, Lord allows. Yes, now Corona is in the world. God alone. Why we people are not glorifying God? We are not living according to God. Our standard of God's standard is gone away. We are not living sincere people, holy people, dedicated people, divine people. We are doing all kind of nonsense things, all kind of things what God does not like. That's why God allowed evil. Bible says, if my people, those who are called by name, we people, we are called by name, by his name. So, we have to come out from the evil. We have to pray, we have to seek the law. When we come out from the evil and look unto God, live like God, evil will not be in the land. Christians, born again Christians, spiritual Christians, so-called leaders, we should not be rooted in evil. Yes. When we look unto the world, we come to God, we come closer to God. We have to think our life, we have to rededicate our life. We have to go back to God and ask God, God, we should not see evil in the land, Master. So, Lord, the Father, please, Lord, give us good thing, Master, not evil. We have to turn to God. Proverbs chapter 17 verse says, whoso rewardeth evil for God, evil shall not depart from their house. Children of the Lord, we should do good Are we doing good or we are doing evil for good things? When we do good for evil, evil will be in our own only. Some so-called leaders, they are doing evil to good things. Because of us only they will come up. But they will not realize about those things. They want their family, they want the relatives, they want the people, those who are supporting them for evil. For that, they will do evil for good things. When the good people, those who are doing good, if you are getting evil by the people, those who are receiving good from you, don't worry, look unto God. God will punish those families. Bible says, Matthew 5:39, resist not the evil. Children of the Lord, whosoever smite thee on the right cheek, turn to the other also. We are not resist the devil. We have to be with God only. 1 Thessalonians 5:15 says, we should not render evil for evil unto any man. Yes, if any man does evil also, we should not do evil. We have to do good. Through our good work, evil people has to be changed. If evil people has to be changed, we people, committed people, we people, those who worshipping God truly, we have to do good for evil also. Are we doing that? Bible says, 1 Timothy 6:10, the love of money is root of all evil. We should have money. Money is needed for everything. But lust of the money. We should not have lust for money. So nowadays so-called leaders, world leaders, they are saying themselves as leaders of the world. For money, for their families, relatives, they do all kind of evil. But we should be a people of God. We should not have lust for money. When lust for money comes, we will do all kind of evil. So we have to come out from those. Matthew 6:13 says, we have to ask the Lord to deliver us from evil. Yes, we should have a special prayer for evil. Are we praying for God, praying to God to deliver us from evil? Yes, we have to. Fourth one, not forgiving. Mark 11:26 says, we should forgive others. Then not forgiving comes, our life will be collapsed. Bible says, when we look into Genesis 50:7, godly man Joseph, he forgave his brother. God made him high. So we have to forgive others. Blood relatives, our brethren will do wrong thing only. Yes, that is the nature of brothers and sisters. But what we have to do, if you are committed, the surrender of a life fully to God, if you are saying, Lord, make me as a vessel for your glory, we have to be a people of forgiveness. Are we forgiving or not forgiving? Exodus 32:2 says, when Israel made gods of gold, Moses asked the forgiveness and said, if not forgive them, blot me out of the book. Master, Lord, we have to have heart like Moses. We have to cry like Moses for our people. Are we doing that? Bible says, Matthew 6:12, are we forgiving our debtors? If we forgive our debtors, only God will forgive our debts. Are we doing that? Matthew 6:14 says, if you forgive men that trespasses, then our Father will forgive our trespasses. Are we forgiving others? Or taking revenge? Taking revenge is not just for us. Taking revenge is evil. Satan will take revenge. Satanic people will take revenge. But we people called by God, be people committed to God. We have to be a people of forgiving. So we have to forgive others. Next one, Bible says, Ephesians 5:6, disobedience. Lord's anger comes upon disobedient children. We have to obey to the Lord's word. If we live without obedience to the Lord's word, we are in great sin. The person who disobeys Lord's word, his anger will come upon him. Children of God, they may say, we are escaped while they are in death, but surely they will not enter into heaven. We should obey to Lord's word. Disobedient people will not enter into heaven. When we look into Jesus, our Lord, while he was in earth, he obeyed to his Father. Until the cross, he obeyed. Are you obeying? Man of the Lord, children of the Lord, when we obey to God's word, when we obey to God, then only our promotion will come. Are we obeying to God? Disobedience will another evil for us to spoil our life. Fifth one, I mind that Romans chapter 11 verse 20 says, we should not have I minded. We live by grace. His grace and mercy and love saved us. We are Gentile. We are away from God. But his grace made us to be his children. So we should not have anything to boast also. Children of the Lord, what kind of mind we are having? Every mind, I mind, thinking us as higher than others, thinking about us as greater than others, not because of others, because of me. No, we must be people of humble, we must be people of high-minded. We have to be a correct people, we have to be a sincere people, we have to be a people of God. Children of the Lord, what Bible says? We should not boast anything. His grace made us to live. Because of His grace only we are living. So, when I mind comes, when we think higher than others, please go to the presence of God. Kneel down before God and humble yourself. When I mind comes no, that is the last stage, we will go away from the Lord also. So be a people of God. Leviticus 19:17 says, 7:28, we should not hate others. We have to love. We should not love. That is sin. But love sinners to accept our Lord as the Lord and Savior. Genesis 3:15 says, hating nature of it is called as killing. Lord and his people hate sin. It's good on Nida. Lord hates sin means we should hate sin. We should not hate sinners. Jude 1:23 says, we have to hate even the garments spotted by the flesh. Yes. We should not hate others. We should love others. Love means godly love. We should not have worldly love. Because of the worldly love, so many people are separated. So many Christians' families are separated. So many ministers' families are separated. Because of the worldly love. That means fleshly love. But we should have a godly love. Bible says in Proverbs 13:24, he that spareth his rod, heareth his son. We have to correct our children. When they are going away from Lord, we have to correct them. Using rod is not sin, but loving them, what they are doing is correct. We are hating our children. So, we have to hate the wrong things. Evil ones hate God and his people. They are evils, but we should not hate all. Except Satan and sin, we must love everyone. So, when we look into those things, it will spoil our life. If we have these things in our life, we will not have victorious life. Our end will not be a blessed one. So, we must come out from pride. We must come out from envy. We must come out from evil. We must come out from not forgiving. We should not do disobedience. We have to come out from high-minded and hate. If we are living without these things now, our life will be blessed. Let us look unto God. Father God, I thank you and worship thee for this wonderful morning, Master. You are the glorious God, God the Father. What are the things you don't like in our life, Master? Those things we should not have in our life, Master. Father God, help us to come out from this and live for your glory only. I commit the people, if anyone is Corona people is watching this video, if any Corona affected family is listening this video, help those people in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them receive healing. Lord the Father, with any expectation, they are watching, bless them all, Master. They should not be lack for anything. You are the Lord of blessing. You are the Lord of glory. That's a great thing, Master. So I commit each and everyone into your mighty and bless everyone for your glory. Until we meet next week, Master, be with us. We give all the glory and honor to you only. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Please pray for our family, Shelton, Steve and Sheba. Let us join together. Glorify our God. Hallelujah. Amen.